Merhaba, I'm Clara. Today I want to talk about how it was like to be at school in Izmir, Turkey. In Turkey, I was in the 11th grade, which is the second last year of high school. In Belgium, I actually already finished my high school, and that's why I was doing a gap year in Turkey. So if I would take you with me on a random Monday at school, the day would start like this. In the morning, we would have the İstiklal Marşı, where everybody stands up and they sing the national anthem. The national anthem in Turkey is way more important than the national anthem in Belgium. A lot of people in Belgium don't even know the lyrics of the national anthem, including myself. But in Turkey, even I know most of the lyrics because we sang it every Monday before school and every Friday after school. So then we enter our class and the teacher walks in. The teacher says, "Günaydın." All of the students stand up. We say, "Teşekkürler." Thank you. We sit when he says, "Oturabilirsiniz." You can sit. Being in high school in Turkey was also a very different experience from being in high school in Belgium, because I think we had to work way harder in school, in class. Some teachers were actually really good and gave interesting classes, but some other teachers that just sometimes didn't feel like it and they would sit in the cafeteria while we could stay in class, and the students in class, they would put on some music and dance, which was really nice, or sleep, or draw, or just talk, or whatever. As long as we were not being too loud, everything was going fine. Also, sometimes we watched a movie because we had like an interactive screen. So we would watch movies or listen to music on that, which was really nice for me as an exchange student, but probably not prepare yourself for examinations if you are a real student. Also, my fellow students, my friends, they were super helpful. They sat next to me in class to help me out, understanding what was going on in the course, or I was writing down what the teacher said as an exercise for myself, and then they would correct it. And I even wrote my exams together with the class, but during the exams, my friends would sit next to me to help me out with that as well, on some exams, not on everything, but still. They were really nice, so I had a great time with my fellow students as well. So then let's talk about sport class. I think sport class wasn't really sport class for me. We didn't even have a uniform in my school in Belgium. We had a uniform, you know, and you run, you do sports, you sweat. And yeah, in my school we went to the cafeteria and we drank some tea or ate something, or we talked. Sometimes we did some sport, but most of the time if we did some sport it was volleyball. We would be in a circle and throw the volleyball to each other, or we would play ping pong, and that's all. Even the teacher was most of the time just sitting with us. If we wanted to do some sport, we obviously could ask, but most of the time nobody really felt like it, so we didn't do anything. But sometimes in the breaks we had a volleyball tournament. And I always thought it was very interesting because people didn't only play volleyball with the hands, but also with the feet. Another thing which I found interesting was the relationship between the teacher and the student. In Belgium, we don't really have a good relationship with the teacher. They can be friendly, obviously, but we don't have a deep connection or something. I'm not saying in Turkey there was a very deep connection, but the way they would interact would be different. For example, I remember teacher high-fiving students, or if you don't understand something, the teacher would just come sit next to you on the bench and explain things to you, and they would call the students arkadaşlarım, which means my friends, or they would say çocuklarım, which means my kids. So the relationship between the teacher and the student was kind of closer, but still they had respect for one another. Another important person I want to talk about is the müdür, the school principal. He was also very kind and well respected, and he even offered me to drink some tea in his office a couple of times, and always told me that I could come to him if I have any problems. For the students, it was also very important to show the respect to the principal. And yes, I say show because of the example I'm going to give. In Belgium, when you want to show your respect, you just be polite and that's respectful. But in Turkey, for example, I was sitting with my legs crossed and then the müdür walked by and my friends were hitting my leg and telling me to put my legs next to each other because apparently it's not polite to sit with legs crossed. Obviously, this is showing the respect. This doesn't always mean that you really have respect for the person. And when the end of the school day came closer, a lot of people tried to escape from school. And I say escape because they didn't just walk out the door. No, they climbed over the fence. And the school guard said that if you climb over the fence, you escape at your own risk. So if he opens the door for you, yeah, he's actually not allowed to do that because you should be in class. But luckily, a good friend of mine and I got along with the doorman pretty well. And also, I was actually walking with crutches most of the time of the year because I had a knee injury. So the doorman would just let us leave through the door, even if it was too early, so that we could play tavla and drink some tea. So now you got a little insight on how it was like to be in a Turkish high school. For me, your experience might be different. If you have any other experiences you wanted to share with me, leave a comment down below. And if you have questions which are travel related or language related or about my exchange in Turkey, leave them down below as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. Consider subscribing to my channel if you want more videos like this. And then I will see you in the next video.